Welcome to a Bambuser tutorial. During this session, we will walk you through the stats page and the KPIs. This page is accessible if you are an admin or host with privilege. Let's start. Click Stats. In this section, you will see stats from shows that are not created as test shows, as these do not produce any stats that impact data for your live shows. In here, you will see an overview of your shows. You can search for a show title, filter on time period, hide untitled shows, and export all the data in a CSV file. In the top corner, you see two tabs, show list and summary. We're gonna start with show list. To see specific show data, click on a show. In the top here, you can see the title of the show, you can see when it went live, and how long it was. You can also export the CSV file here for this specific show. Let's explore the KPIs. First, viewers. This is divided into total, live, and recorded. Total is total unique viewers. For example, if a viewer has seen both the live and recorded show, it will still be one. Nonetheless, if a viewer saw both, they will be counted as one live and one recorded, and that is why this number sometimes doesn't add up. The average viewing time, this is also divided between total, live and recorded, and you can see the percentage of the total show here. If you have conversion tracking implemented and have sold products from your live show, this will be measured of total amount and number of purchases. However, it will not be divided between live and recorded. If a purchase has been made in a different currencies, you can see this by clicking here. US dollar, Swedish krona. You can also filter between a 30 days window and a 7 day window. So, what does this mean? By filtering between the different time span, you can analyze the amount and how many purchases that has happened, for instance, 7 days after a viewer watched the show. Perfect. The next part here, the live engagement. This graph showcases the viewers' interactions minute by minute of the show. A good tip here, learn from the curves and identify what content triggers their actions. You can also filter by clicking on each box, depending on what you would like to see. The next graph here is post-live engagement. This is a great tool to analyze engagement happening after your live show. In here, you can filter on time period and what KPI you would like to see as summary, max, and average. Perfect. The last part here is engagement. In here, you can analyze add to cart, chat, likes, and on device. And of course, as you can see, this is also divided between live, recorded, and total. Important note here, if you do not have cart integration, where you can add to cart directly in the player, these stats will not be populated. This page is very important for you and a team to analyze your shows and find areas of improvements. Perfect! Now let's jump into the summary tab. The stats summary page presents aggregated KPIs and statistics about the activity registered on any show available on your site in a selected period of time. You will, by default, see the performance of the last 3 months. You can of course filter for a new time frame. But what do we categorize as an activity? We classify a show as with activity if there has been at least viewing or sales activity related to it. The dashboard is based on activity, or how it's called, activity-centric, which means that we are including the activity registered in any shows that you have had available to be consumed in the selected period of time. We are not limiting to include only the shows that have been broadcasted in the selected period. So, which KPIs are included? First, shows with activity, divided between total and split, during the time frame and outside. By clicking on shows included, you can see which shows are included in the overview and the viewers and sales they've had in the selected time frame. You will then have the possibility to access the desired show by clicking on its items on the list. Perfect. Product added to cart. This is how many products have been added to the cart. Total viewing time. How many hours watched in live, recorded, and total. Viewers. A sum of unique viewers per show. Sales. Amount and number of purchases, the same KPI is also available in the other stats page. The last part here, viewers retention. This graph to the right shows how many unique viewers have watched at least 1, 2, 3, or 4 shows in the selected period. The calculation is based on session data that is stored for 30 days after the user's last interaction with your show. For this reason, we might underestimate the retention value, which is viewers inactive for more than 30 days gets a new session and then they are considered as a new viewers. As always, if you need any help, click help or contact us. In here you can search for more information. Perfect! This is how you analyze your stats and data. Watch our Bambuser tutorials for education and guidance. Thank you for watching.